Theory in the last class we learnt about HCF and different methods to find HCF of given numbers and different standard types related to the HCF we discussed in the last class. And now in this class this is completely about least common multiple, and least common multiple is simply written as LCM, and I am going to deal with LCM in this class. Okay, so for suppose if we have two numbers 12 and 18, we need to find its LCM by definition method as well as by prime factorization method and then with the division method. See, first thing is definition method. Definition method in the sense we need to follow its word least common multiple. That means we need to list out multiples and then identify common multiples. Among those we need to find, among them we need to identify the least one, and that is the least common multiple. So since I have 12 and 18. See, for 12, what are the multiples of 12? Multiples of 12 are, see, as we learnt about the multiples, 12, 24, 36, 48, 16, and so on are the multiples of 12. Whereas coming to 18, and what you say about multiples of 18? And multiples of 18 are simply nothing but 18, 36, 54, 72, 90 and so on. After the 60 we have here again 72, right? 12, 6 and then 84, like that. Now these are the multiples of 12 and then these are the multiples of 18. What are the common multiples? See, look here, 36 is a common multiple for both 12 and 18. And the same way 72 is also a common multiple for both 12 and 18. So if you wish to list out, therefore common multiples are, common multiples are 36 is the first and the least common multiple, and then 72, okay, and then if you check you will get 108 as the common multiple, okay, after that you will get 144 as a common multiple, like that we will exit, we will proceed, okay. When you observe these common multiples, among these common multiples, say this 36 is the least common multiple, the 36 is the least one. And since multiples exist for infinite times, see, multiples exist for many numbers, so highest common multiple, okay, is infinite. Highest common multiple. As I mentioned you in the last class, along with HCF, LCF also I mentioned you. Actually, there exist four different terms, okay, least common factor, highest common factor, least common multiple, highest common multiple, okay. Highest common multiple is usually not exist because there exist infinite number of common multiples, so it is not easy to identify the highest common multiple. So highest common multiple always not exist. You just take any numbers, any pair of any group of numbers, always highest common multiple not exist. In the same way, you just take any group of numbers, always least common multiple is 1. Since always it is fixed as 1, since always it is fixed as not exist, so no need to think about this LCF and HCF for different group of numbers. But this HCF, highest common factor, as well as LCM, least common multiple, these two values, these two terms and the values are different for different groups of numbers. So our task is to find out this HCF and LCM, and that HCF and LCM concept helps us in solving different word problems and different situations also. I mentioned you related to HCF in the last class, and now I will give you some standard problems related to the LCM. Okay. So at the end, by definition method, for 12 these are the multiples, for 18 these are the multiples, and common multiples are this list, and among these common multiples, this 36 is the least one, and so this 36 is the LCM of the given two numbers. Okay, have a look. Next, finding LCM by prime factorization method. As we discussed in last class for HCF, here again we are going to find LCM by prime factorization method. For that, first of all, you need to prime factorize this 12, since 12 is 4 into 3, so 2 square into 3. Whereas 18 is 2 into 9, and that is 2 into 3 square. So I have prime factorization for the given two numbers. And to find LCM, simply what we do is we need to find out. See, that means we need to list every prime number with the highest power. Whereas for HCF, we are thinking about the minimum value of the powers. But for LCM, we need to think about the maximum value of the power. Here 2 power 1 and 2 square. So 2 square is the 2 is the highest power for this 2. Whereas coming to 3, here 3 power 1 and 3 square. Again, if you observe, this 2 is the highest number. So we need to take 2 for LCM. 2 square into 3 square, 36 is the LCM by prime factorization method. For suppose if we have two numbers like n1 is equals to 2 power alpha 1, 3 power alpha 2, 5 power alpha 3, like that. As I said in the last class, n2 is equals to 2 power beta 1, 3 power beta 2, 5 power beta 3, and so on. Then if you wish to write LCM of this n1 and n2, LCM of n1 and n2 is equals to 2 power. In this 2 power, we need to take the maximum of these two. 2 power maximum of alpha 1 comma beta 1 into 3 power maximum of alpha 2 comma beta 2, and so on. So like that we need to continue. So with that particular logic, here LCM is 2 square into 3 square. We are searching for the multiples, and that too for the common multiples. Multiple is always that number given n1 or that given number into something. Again, multiple for 18 is the same number into something. But what we need to find? We need to find out the least common multiple, right? So there exist many multiples for this. So 2 square into 3 into 1, 2 square into 3 into 2, 2 square into 3 into 3. All these are the multiples of 12. So again, we need to list out multiples for this 18. By listing those common multiples, we have to identify the least one, and it becomes the least, and the value is 36. Okay, have a look, and you need to memorize this. If you have two numbers with its prime factorization, then HCF is the prime numbers with powers as minimum of alpha 1 beta 1, whereas LCM is prime numbers with their powers as maximum of this alpha 1 beta 1, maximum of alpha 2 beta 2, like that. Next, you may say division method or shortcut method for LCM of 12 and 18. Here you will take 12 and 18 in this way, and we need to check each and every prime number which will cancel out this 12 and 18. For suppose if you take 3, 3 4 is 12, 3 6 is 18, and then you just move with the 2, 2 2 is 4, 2 3 is 6. So this 2 and 3 have no common factor, so there is no common prime number in this 2 and 3. So at the end, our LCM is nothing but this 3 into 2 into this 2 into 3, and that is 36. 36 is the LCM of that given 12 and 18. So this is simply what you may call division method or shortcut method. You just take any numbers. Usually to find the LCM, we usually follow this shortcut method, and sometimes we use prime factorization method. For suppose if I have 12, 18, and you may take some other number. Okay, yeah, what I have to take is some 45. What is the LCM of this 12, 18, and 45? How to calculate? You just go with this 12, 18, 45. Use this shortcut method. Okay, in which table we have to move? First of all, I am starting with 3. 3 4 is 12, 3 6 is 18, and 3 15 is 45. And then 4 6 15. So you need to move with the, either with these two exist in 3 table, and these two are possible with 2 table, you just go with 2 table or with 3 table. Okay, 3. Okay, see, just write 4. 3 2 is 6, 3 5 is 15. And now leave this 5, but 2 is a factor for this 4 and 2. So 2 2s is 4, 2 1s, and then 5. At the end, the product of all these numbers, 3 into 3, 9. Into 2, 18, into 2, 36, into 5, 180. So finally, 180 is the LCM of this 12, 18, and 45. And this is division method or shortcut method to find LCM. I think you are very familiar with this, and I will give you different standard problems related to the LCM. Okay, have a look. Now that's the problem. Find the least number which is exactly divisible by 12, 15, and 21. See, just read out the problem. In the last class, we learned similar type of problems for HCF, and now we are going to solve different problems related to the LCM. See, you just read out the problem, find the least number which is exactly divisible by 12. See, initially if you don't know that number, let that number as some n. And as per the problem, least number which is divisible by 12, that means this n is divisible by 12. So if you divide n with 12, it leaves a remainder of 0. If you divide n with 12, it leaves a remainder of 0. In the same way, if you divide n with 15, it leaves a remainder 0. And if you divide n with 21, it leaves a remainder 0. And we know that n, see, in this part of division, if remainder is 0, as I mentioned in the last class, this is the position of multiple and this is the position of factor. For HCF, we need to find this place, okay? For LCM, we need to find this place, as I said, okay? This is the position of multiple and this is the position of factor. While solving problems related to the HCF, we don't know this particular place, and here we just take that unknown place as some n, and then we found that n. But in the multiples, we need to find out this particular position, okay? Right. As for that problem, find the least number which is exactly divisible by 12. Initially, that number is n, that n is divisible by 12, so remainder is 0. N is divisible by 15, so remainder is 0. N is divisible by 21, so remainder is 0. Okay. So what it represents now? N is a multiple of 12. N is a multiple of 15. N is a multiple of 21 also. Since N is multiple of 12, N is multiple of 15, N is multiple of 21, and these three at a time we have, and that's why N is a common multiple of 12, 15 and 21, but the question is asking us to find the least number. So finally we conclude that N is least common multiple of 12, 15 and 21. Now, see, next task is to find the LCM of these three numbers in all possible, possibility. For suppose 12 is simply nothing but 2 square into 3, whereas 15 is simply 3 into 5 and 21 is equals to 3 into 7. Then n is simply the least common multiple of these three numbers. See, first of all, you just take 2. Here 2 power 2. Since 2 is not involved here, you may take that as 2 power 0. And here again 2 power 0. We need to write the highest power, so 2 into 3. So 3 power 1, 3 power 1, 3 power 1. So 3 with power 1, because 1 is same everywhere, right? Next, coming to 5. See, if you observe here, no 5 is involved, that means 5 power 0. And here it is 5 power 1. Since no 5 is involved, 5 power 0. Think about the powers of 5 and write the highest one. 0, 1, 0. Highest number is 1, maximum number, so 5 power 1. The same way 7 power 1. We need to multiply this. 2 square is 4, 3 is 12, 12, 5 is 60, 67 is 420. So n is 420. So the least number which is exactly divisible by these three numbers is nothing but 420. Then it's the problem. Okay, have a look. Just analyze the problem. Okay, actually, why we are using LCM to answer this particular question? This is because of analyzing and understanding the given question. That's it. Okay. At the end, if you wish to generalize the problem, the least number which is exactly divisible by x, y, and z. The least number which is exactly divisible by x, y, and z is simply LCM of x, y, z. You just memorize in such a way. There are three rules, or you may say three standard problems related to HCF. And in the same way, here again, we have three standard problems or rules related to LCM. Among those, the first one is this. If the question is like that, your answer is LCM of XYZ. So find the least possible number which when divided by 18, 35 and 42 leaves the remainders 2, 19 and 26 respectively. Find the least possible number which when divided by 18. So initially, if you don't know that number, let n be the required number, then as per the problem, if you divide n with 18, which when divided by 18 leaves remainder 2. And the next case, which n divided by 35 leaves remainder 19. And the next thing is, when you divide that n with the 42, it leaves a remainder 26. Now what we need to do? We need to find out plausible value of n. See, when you divide n with 18, 2 is the remainder. When you divide n with 35, 19 is the remainder. When you divide n with 42 and 26 is the remainder. Okay. To solve this problem, one observation is, you just check the difference between this 18 and 18 as given. 2 as given. 18 and 2, the difference is 16. 35 and 19, here again the difference is 16. 42 and 26, here again the difference is 16. Okay. In this case, what I am doing is, actually we know different remainder properties. If you subtract some number from this n, automatically you have to subtract from this remainder also. If you add some number to this n, you need to add the same number for this 2 also. See, the next step is simply nothing but, this implies, I will add 16 for this n. N plus 16, when you divide with 18, you left with a remainder of 2 plus 16. 2 plus 16 is what? 18 actually. And this 18 will leave us a remainder of 0 at the end. If you add 16 for that number n, and you are dividing with 18, it leaves remainder 0. Because n is leaving 2, since you add 16, you need to add 16 for this 2 also. 2 plus 16 is 18, and we are dividing with 18, the remainder is 0. In the same way here again. Here again, you just add 16. If you add 16 for this n, and you are dividing with 35, then the remainder is 19 plus 16. 19 plus 16 is again 35, and we are dividing with 35, it leaves a remainder of 0. And in the same way here again, you just add 16. If you add 16 for this n, and we are dividing with 42, remainder is 26 plus 16, which is 42, leaves a remainder of 0. Now you just try to understand. This number n plus 16 leaves remainder 0 when divided by 18, leaves remainder 0 when divided by 35, leaves remainder 0 when divided by 42. Now, when you observe these three divisions, these three are just similar to the previous problem. And from there we conclude that n plus 16 is simply nothing but LCM of 18, 35 and 42. Just like 13a, you need to write that n plus 16 as LCM of these three numbers. Now, find the LCM of these three numbers, and then you just find that n plus 16 value. From there we will get the value of n, and that n is the required least possible number. Okay. So what is the LCM of this 18, 35 and 42? We have many possibilities to solve to find the LCM of these three numbers. Okay? Yeah. What I do is just write 18 as 2 into 3 square. And 35, 5 into 7, 42, 2 into 3 into 7. Now LCM is simply nothing but coming to 2, you need to take 2. Coming to 3, 3 square you need to take, because we need to consider power of 3 as the highest number. And coming to 5, 5 and then 7. So 3 square is 9, 2 is 18, 5 is 90 and 6, 30 is n plus 16. Since we need to find n, 630 minus 16, which is equals to 614. So finally the answer for the problem, least possible number which when divided by 18, 35 and 42 leaves the remainders 12 and 19, 26 respectively, is 614. You just check it. Okay. Actually, if you take 630, when you divide 630 with 18, 630 with 35, 630 with 42, it leaves a remainder 0. But when you divide 614 with 18, leaves remainder 2. 614 with 35 leaves remainder 19. 614 with 42 leaves remainder 26. See, actually this part is enough to write the answer for the problem. But why we are doing in this such way, in this way? Why n plus 16 is LCM of this 18, 35 and 42? So just to generate this particular line, I explained you through these division parts. Okay, have a look. If you wish to generalize this problem, find the least possible number which when divided by x, y and z leaves the remainders p, q and r respectively. Then in this case, what is the least possible number? What is our answer? First of all, we need to observe one thing. Okay, observation. See, we need to observe the difference between this given x, y, z along with the p, q, r. Okay, x, y, z, p, q, r. You just observe the difference. What is this x minus p? What is this y minus q? What is that z minus r? What I am going to tell you is, if the difference is constant, then then it is easy to answer the problem, right? X minus p is equals to y minus q is equals to z minus r is equals to a constant. If you say that constant has some k, therefore answer for this problem as we discussed is n is equals to LCM of x, y, z minus k. Is it right? If the difference is a constant k, then our required number n is simply LCM of x, y, z minus k. Why? The explanation is the discussed example. Okay, I discussed with the numbers and I am generalizing with the variables x, y, z and p, q, r. You just try to memorize. If you memorize this particular line, then there is no need to do the division, there is no need to mention the division form and no need to do everything. Directly write the required number as this LCM minus k, you get answer. Okay. So find the least number which when divided by 24, 32 and 42 leaves the remainder 4 in each case. Initially we don't know the answer, let that number as n. Okay, I am just giving you the explanation part first and then I will generalize the problem. That generalization helps us as a shortcut to solve these problems in exams. Okay, first of all, initially we are taking the number as n. As per the given situation, when you divide n with 24, it leaves remainder 4. That's the problem, right? Just read out the question. Find the least number which when divided by 24 leaves remainder 4, which when divided by 32, again it leaves a remainder 4, and when you divide n with 42, again it leaves a remainder 4. Okay, always 4 is the remainder. So 4 4 4. See, we are familiar with the properties of remainders from our previous classes. Since it is 4, if you subtract 4 from this remainder, you need to subtract the same 4 from the dividend also. So what I am going to do is n, when you divide with 24, you just subtract 4 from the dividend as well as from the remainder. N minus 4 is here again 4 minus 4. I am just subtracting 4. Okay, 4 minus 4 is what? 0, right? So when you divide n minus 4 with 24, it leaves remainder 0. In the same way, when you divide n minus 4 with 32, it leaves a remainder 0. When you divide n minus 4 with 42, again it leaves a remainder 0. From this, one thing is very clear, that n minus 4 is a multiple of 24, n minus 4 is a multiple of 32, n minus 4 is a multiple of 42. So n minus 4 is a common multiple because n is same. So n minus 4 is a common multiple. The question is asking us to find the least number. So n minus 4 is simply nothing but LCM of 24 comma 32 comma 42. So again, how to find out the LCM? Either you may go with prime factorization method or with a shortcut method. See, just n square is 8 threes, so 2 cube into 3. 32 is 2 power 5, whereas 42 is 2 into 3 into 7, right? That these are the prime factorizations. So just n minus 4 is equals to, now 2 power, we need to write the maximum value of the 2 powers in the numbers. 2 power 3, 2 power 5, 2 power 1, the maximum value is 5. Whereas coming to 3, 3 power 1, 3 power 0, 3 power 1, so 3. Coming to 5, not involved, and 7. So now this is the LCM. And n minus 4 is this 2 power 5 into 3 into 7. 7 into 3 is 21. 2 power 5 is 32. 32 into 21. What is 32 into 21? 21 2's is 42. So 2. 21 3's is 63. And then 4. 67. 672. N minus 4 is 672 and n is 672 plus 4, that is equals to 676, and then this 676 is our answer. Okay, so these two division representations just helps us to analyze the problem. Okay, from there we conclude that our answer is 676. Now generalization. Find the least number which when divided by x, y and z leaves the same remainder, some r, in each case. Then what you say about the required answer? Required answer n is simply nothing but LCM of x, y, z. LCM of x, y, z, right? LCM of x, y, z plus remainder r is the generalization for the problem. Okay, here again 13a and 13b, 13c, we did three different problems related to LCM. See, you need to analyze question every time for 13a, 13b, 13c, and to generalize these three problems I gave you division representations. From there we generated a shortcut rule, and this is shortcut rule for 13c. In the same way, you need to memorize shortcut rule for 13a and 13b also. Okay, right. Just look at the board. We have two different problems, and these two problems are bit different with the problems of 13. Okay, every problem needs your analyzation and a plan, and then you need to implement that plan to solve the problem. Okay, just have a look. 14a and 14b. So first look at 14a. See, find the least number which when divided by 4, 6, 8 and 12 leaves 1 as remainder. See, when you divide a number with 4, with 6, with 8 and 12, always it leaves 1 as a remainder. This is just of the form 13c. Then if you think that number, see, just when you consider this part, when you consider only this part, then the possible value of n is simply nothing but LCM of 4, 6, 8 and 12 plus 1. Okay, so n is equals to what you say about LCM of all these numbers. See, simply if you check, I think so 24 is the LCM. Okay, because 4, 6, 24, 6, 4 and then 8, 3 and then 12, 2. So just calculate in your way, 24 is the LCM, 24 is the LCM. Okay, so actually when you check that, what we call 13c, n is equals to LCM of these numbers plus 1. So from there we write that n minus 1 is equals to 24, is it right? What I am going to tell you is this 24 is the least common multiple. Okay, right. Along with this 24, you just mention all the multiples. If you wish to find least number, then 24 is enough. But actually there are many other possibilities other than the least. So n minus 4 is equals to 24 or 48, 72 or 96, 24 5 is 120, like that. All these are the multiples of 24. What I am going to tell you is when you divide 24 with these numbers, always remainder is 0. When you divide 48 with these numbers, remainder is 0. When you divide 72 with these numbers, remainder is 0. When you divide 96 with these numbers, remainder is 0. That means all these numbers are the common multiples of this 4, 6, 8 and 12. All these are the common multiples. But if our target is to find the least, so usually we take 24. Okay. So, but since we need to find out, we need to check the other part, I just mentioned you all the common multiples. Now what is n? You just add 1 to every number. Now that implies n is equals to, you just add 1 for this left side as well 1 for right side. So now n is equals to 25 common 49, common 73, common 96 plus 1, what it is? 97, common 121, and so on. Now, see, all these numbers are possible values according to the question. Check it. Consider this 25. Divide this 25 with 4, leaves 1 as remainder. 49 with 6 leaves 1 as remainder. Okay, 49 with 8 leaves 1 as remainder. 49 with 12 leaves 1 as remainder. Not only 25, not only 49, take anything. First, suppose you just take this 121. Divide 121 with 4, 1 is remainder. Divide 121 with 6, 1 is remainder. Divide 121 with 8 or with 12, 1 is the remainder. But all these numbers are the possible, but since least is underlined word here, so our target is this 25 actually. But the question is more than this. But when divided by 7 leaves no remainder. If the question is just to find the least number, our answer is 25. But here the question is not only to find the least, but also the number is a multiple of 7. Because when you divide that number with 7, leaves no remainder, means leaves 0 as remainder. When you divide 25 with 7, 0 is not the remainder. But when you divide this 49 with 7, sure 0 is the remainder. So you need to give 49 as your answer for this problem. Because this problem involves with two checkings, two conditions. According to the first condition, 25 is the required least number. But when you check the second condition, 49 is the required least number. Okay. So usually for standard types, 13ABC, these type of shortcut rules are enough. But when the problem is more than the standard type, you need to go with the common multiples. From there, you need to find out the possible values of n. Among those possible values, according to the question, we need to answer. Since the question is about finding a least number which is a multiple of 7, 49 is our answer. For suppose the question is about find the least number which when divided by 4, 6, 8 and 12 leaves 1 as remainder, and that number is a third 3-digit number. If the question is asking in such a way, then your answer is 121. 121 is this least 3-digit number satisfying the given condition. Then at that question you need to answer 121 as your answer. Okay. See, observe these numbers, and among these numbers, according to the second condition, we need to give our answer. Okay. Have a look.
So in the same way, you just try 14B.